Hi, it's Matt Winebarger with the TEEX Rope Access Level 1 course. What you're about to see is a video, short little video on all of our Level 1 tasks. Just a quick overview, kind of show you what you're actually going to receive while taking the class. First half of the day will be in class. We'll go over basic harness anatomy and basic knots to actually get you set up to start individual tasks. All individual tasks are going to be instructor-led. I will perform the task first and then you will copy. Day 2, we'll get into your basic individual tasks to include rope-to-rope transfers and the very beginning stages of rescues. We'll cover ascending and descending through knots and through other obstacles. This course is mainly hands-on. You will only spend a very minimal amount of time in the classroom, and we only cover the very basic information in the classroom to actually get you more ready for your hands-on portions. What you're seeing here is you're seeing students from the very first pilot class performing rope-to-rope transfers and ascending and descending. This right here is your rescue task, and it actually covers two rescues in one swift motion, rescuing from the ascending equipment and rescues from the descending equipment. As you see here, it looks complicated, but the more hands-on you receive throughout the course, the faster and smoother this all becomes. As you see here, this is another rescue. This is the actual rescuer ascending to the casualty to actually perform his rescue. On day 4, it will be self-led. These are all the tasks we cover throughout Level 1. On day 4, I set up a checkoff board for you to go through the individual tasks at your own pace to make sure you're ready for evaluation on day 5. If you have questions during your individual tasks, feel free to always ask the instructor for help, and we can help you lead through any tasks that you may be having trouble with, or just clarification or pointers as you complete these tasks. On day 5, you will have a third-party evaluator, independent from our organization, conduct your evaluation. There is no exact time standard for any of these tasks. Everything is at your pace, but you must make progress throughout each task. If at any point in time, the evaluator stops you, it is to ask you questions about what you're doing or to explain a discrepancy that may have occurred during one of your tasks. You are allowed to receive 2 minor discrepancies. On a third minor discrepancy, you are a fail. And then 1 major discrepancy will disqualify you from evaluation. And as you can see here, one of our students is performing his rescue for evaluation while the other students are prepping for other activities. Thank you for watching our video. Again, my name is Matthew Winebarger. Feel free to contact me if you would like more information about the course.